إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. أفمن يعلم أنما أنزل إليك من ربك الحق كمن هو أعمى إنما يتذكر أولو الألباب. هل يستوي من يعلم ومن يؤمن بما أنزل إليك يا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم ومن يعلم ولا يؤمن ولا يصدق ولا يلتزم؟ لا يتذكر ذلك ولا يتعظ بذلك ولا يؤمن بذلك إلا أصحاب العقول السليمة، والعقل السليم هو العقل الذي يعقل صاحبه عما يضره ويجلب له النفع، وما سوى ذلك فلا عقل له، فإنها لا تعمى الأبصار ولكن تعمى القلوب التي في الصدور. بس آية من سورة الرعد، الله سبحانه وتعالى is like making a comparison which is very clear to any person with a sound mind that it is not equal. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talking to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, is he the one saying, is he the one who believes in you and believes in the message that has been sent with you, and he believes in it and he acts upon it, is he equal with the person who is blind, meaning he knows the truth and he turns away from it? To Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala compared the disbeliever with the blind person, and other ayat compare the disbeliever with animals, in fact worse than animals. And why? Because the end of the ayah tells you that إِنَّمَا يَتَذَكَّرُ أُولُو الْأَلْبَابِ. People with sound minds are the one who really understand that and believe in it. People with sound mind, not intelligent people. Because you may have a sound mind and not be intelligent or that intelligent. And you may be very intelligent with a horrible mind, not a sound mind. But the sound mind is the mind, when I say mind, I'm referring to the brain. A person with a sound brain is a person that the brain he has brings goodness for him and averts evil from him. That's a sound brain. Other than that, it doesn't matter what kind of intelligence you have. If that doesn't do that, then you are worse than an animal, because the animal that doesn't have a brain or intellect protects itself, or the brain that they have protects them from harm and brings them goodness to them. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala immediately after that start describing people with sound brain. So you can look at it and apply it to yourself and see where you stand. الذين, number one, الذين يوفون بعهد الله ولا ينقضون الميثاق. شرع الله سبحانه وتعالى في أوصاف أصحاب العقول السليمة أو أولو الألباب. أول شيء يوفون بعهد الله ولا ينقضون الميثاق. كلامهم ثابت ووعودهم ثابتة، وهذه صفة المنافقين، نقض العهود وإخلاف المواعيد. So when you have the sound brain, then you keep your word and you don't break your promise, because these are qualities of the hypocrites. That's number one. والذين يصلون ما أمر الله به أن يوصل. Second one, they reach their kinship, their parents, their sisters, their family, their neighbors, their friends, and al-aqrab fil-aqrab. They reach them. يصلون ما أمر الله به أن يوصل من الأهل ومن الأقارب ومن الجيران والفقراء وما سوى ذلك. ويخشون ربهم. هذا العلم أو هذا العقل السليم وهذه الخشية تحملهم على طاعة الله سبحانه وتعالى. يخشون ربهم، they they fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they fear His greatness and they fear His punishment. So this fear makes them act and get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When you fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you go to Him. When you fear human being or other things, you run away from it. That's the difference. Because the fear is based, or the khashya, yani khashya is the better word than fear, because it makes it sound negative when you always say fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Khashya is fear but based on knowledge. You know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so you have khashya. You don't know anything you don't know, you may have fear from it because you don't know it. But once you get to know it, then you may have fear and you may have love. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when you know Him, you fear Him and you love Him. You fear His punishment and you love Him because of His goodness. يَخْشَوْنَ رَبَّهُمْ وَيَخَافُونَ سُوءَ الْحِسَابِ يَعْلَمُونَ أَنَّهُمْ مَوْقُوفُونَ عند الله سبحانه وتعالى يوم القيامة لذلك يعملون لهذا المكان يعني يعدون لهذا الحساب حتى ينجو. They prepare themselves for the day of judgment. They fear the balance, the scale. They fear their bad deeds, so they don't fall in it and they do the obedience. وَالَّذِينَ صَبَرُوا ابْتِغَاءَ وَجْهِ رَبِّهِمْ قَدْ يَصْبِرُ الْإِنسَانُ وَلَيْسَ لِوَجْهِ اللَّهِ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى. فالكافر يصبر. الله سبحانه وتعالى قال يا أيها الذين آمنوا اصبروا وصابروا. قال بعض علماء التفسير يعني كونوا أكثر صبرا من عدوكم. صبر ابتغاء وجه ربكم ربهم. هذا الفرق هو الصبر من أجل ثواب الله سبحانه وتعالى. الصبر على الطاعات والصبر عن المعاصي والصبر على أقدار الله سبحانه وتعالى. When you are patient, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said this is a quality of ulul albab. But this patient is different than any other patient. This is for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because a disbeliever can be patient or more patient than the believer. But the difference is, one is doing it for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and one is just patient. Ibtigha'a wajhi rabbihim, that means they obey for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they stay away from haram for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they accept the destiny of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is sabr. Ibtigha'a wajhi Allah. والذين صبروا ابتغاء وجه ربهم وأقاموا الصلاة. من أعظم الصبر إقامة الصلاة. إقامة الصلاة، أداء الصلاة بأركانها واجباتها وسننها وأوقاتها وما شابه ذلك. And the first thing that you need to be patient on is establishing the prayer at its time, doing it the way the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم did it. صلوا كما رأيتموني أصلي. ويخشون ربهم ويخافون سوء الحساب. والذين صبروا ابتغاء وجه ربهم وأقاموا الصلاة وأنفقوا مما رزقناهم سرا وعلانية. إقامة الصلاة علاقة بينك وبين الله سبحانه وتعالى. This is a relationship between you and Allah سبحانه وتعالى. أنفقوا مما رزقناهم. Spending from your wealth. This is علاقة بينك وبين الإنسان. وهذا يعني من حسنت العلاقة بينه وبين الله سبحانه وتعالى وبينه وبين الناس فهذا هو المؤمن الحق. To be a real good believer, you have to have good relationship with Allah سبحانه وتعالى and good relationship with people. When I say good relationship with people, that means your zakah is paid, you are good with people, your behavior is good, you're not harming, you're not oppressing, you're not committing dhulm or any of that things. وَأَنْفَقُوا سِرًّا وَعَلَانِيَةً. They spend secretly to be more sincere and closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and publicly so they can encourage other ones to do things like this. So they do it accordingly. If I want to give a poor person, I would give him secretly because I don't want to humiliate him. I don't want to show off either. But when I want to do for a good cause like fundraising or masjid for any of that, I do it publicly better than secretly, because when I do it, a lot of people are going to copy me. This is the idea, is I'm doing it to encourage other people not to show other people that I spent on such. So they do both, those people with the sound brains. وَيَدْرَؤُونَ بِالْحَسَنَةِ السَّيِّئَةِ. When something, when they are inflicted with harm with people, they repel it with good, repel evil with good. Not fire with fire, as we say. No, evil with good. Why do they do that? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَأَجْرُهُ عَلَى اللَّهِ وَلَمَنْ عَفَى وَأَصْلَحَ. Anyone who forgives and makes صلح, then أجره from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. والله سبحانه وتعالى دائما يثيب أعظم بكثير مما يحصل عليه الإنسان لو حصل على حقه بنفسه. ولا مانع من حصول الحق بنفس، لكن هنا الله سبحانه وتعالى يقول يدرؤون بالحسنة السيئة. So their quality is they repel evil with good. ادفع بالتي هي أحسن. فإذا الذي بينك وبينه عداوة كأنه ولي حميم. يعني العدو بصير صاحب. هذا عن غالب، لكن في ناس ما في شيء بيغيرهم مهما عملت لهم، وهذول شواذ ما لهم حكم. يعني usually when you do this the enemy becomes a friend, but some people may not change, but we don't care about those people. The rule is for the majority. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said أولئك لهم عقب الدار. These are the one who will have the permanent living in heaven. عقب الدار جنات عدن. فسرها الله سبحانه وتعالى عقب الدار جنات عدن يدخلونها. أي جنات الإقامة الدائمة يدخلونها. ومن صلح من آبائهم وأزواجهم. And anyone who followed their path with righteousness from their family, from their spouses, from their children, they will enter with them. It doesn't matter if someone higher than the other. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bring the lower with the higher as of his graciousness and mercy and love and honor to those people who enter the Jannah. وَالْمَلَائِكَةُ يَدْخُلُونَ عَلَيْهِمْ مِنْ كُلِّ بَابٍ سَلَامٌ عَلَيْكُمْ. Angels will enter at them from every door, greeting them. سَلَامٌ عَلَيْكُمْ أي حَلَّتْ عَلَيْكُمْ السَّلَامَةِ وحلت عليكم النعم السلام من كل مكروه والحصول على كل محبوب والتحية من الله سبحانه وتعالى حلت عليكم بما صبرتم. شوفوا هذا الهدف، بما صبرتم أي بسبب صبركم على الطاعات وابتعادكم عن المعاصي وصبركم على أقدار الله سبحانه وتعالى حصلت لكم هذه المنازل الرفيعة العالية وهذه الجنان وهذه السلامة وهذه التحية من الله سبحانه وتعالى. إذن حقيق على كل إنسان أن ينصح نفسه بأن يمتثل هذه الأوصاف التي وصفها الله سبحانه وتعالى لأصحاب العقول السليمة. So all of this wonderful things that we had in Jannah or you will have in Jannah is because you were patient. When you come to the masjid now, you need patience to come, you need patience to pray, you need patience to wait, you need patience to drive, you need patience to wake up. All of that is the reason for people's success, even in this world. People who are not patient to seek knowledge, they will never get it. People who are not patient to study hard and get better grades and such, they will not get it. So you require patience. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, because of this patience that you had, now you know the decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is always going to pass, then you are patient on that. You don't cuss, you don't curse, you don't complain, you don't say negative things against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You don't say like some people go, why me? Why me? The more I do good, the more Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala treats me bad. This is, you don't even know what doing good is. So therefore, you and I have to advise our own selves. Why can't we take those qualities of those people with sound brains so we can gain and get those jannat that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised for those people who have that. So we pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us all to have qualities of the people with sound minds and admit us to Jannah and all of those we love and all of them, inshallah, will be inshallah in Jannat Adn. اللهم آت نفوسنا تقواها وزكها أنت خير من زكاها أنت وليها ومولاها ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا وانفعنا بما علمتنا وزدنا علما نافعا وجزاكم الله خيرا والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
جزاك الله خير يا شيخ حسن. يا رب.